Hi everyone, how's it going? I know that it's been a while. I'm so sorry. I've been thinking about making this video for months and I'm finally here. So let's get right to it. Today I'm filming a video that I think everyone can relate to, and it's about vocal health, or what do you do if you're constantly suffering from a sore throat, if you feel like your throat is swollen, or if your voice is raspy, or if you're congested. We want to learn how to better take care of our voice so that our throat doesn't get sore after singing. Your throat should be fine after a few hours of singing, but only if you take good care of it. So my first tip for you is to take care of your whole body. So whatever you do for your body is going to translate to your throat. And this is not, you know, this is not as generic as it sounds. If you, you know, if you keep good physical health, then your throat is going to be in good health. But if you don't feed yourself properly, if you don't sleep well, if you are not hydrated, if you don't exercise, then, you know, your throat is going to suffer the consequences as well as every other part of your body. Specific things that I recommend are, for example, doing yoga. I know probably not everyone likes yoga, but the really great thing about yoga is that it teaches you to breathe almost exactly as singing. You're using different parts of your lungs. So for some poses, you're breathing into your lower back, and for some poses, you're breathing into your middle. For almost all the poses, you're filling your lungs from bottom to top, right? And in general, those who practice yoga know that yoga is all about being conscious about your breathing. So your yoga practice and your singing practice are just great complements to each other. But if you don't like yoga, you can also pretty much do any cardio, especially swimming. I don't swim personally, but swimming especially teaches you a lot of the same breath control that singing does. My second tip for you is don't smoke. I don't know why this is still a thing, but I have students who have come to me and they're like, I know smoking is wrong, but I still smoke, or like, I still want that raspy sound that smoking gives me. And newsflash, if you didn't know, you can get a raspy sound without smoking. But what smoking's gonna do to your voice is that it's gonna destroy it. So when you're 50 or 60, you won't be able to sing at all. You won't be able to control your pitch or your tone or your timbre. You're gonna lose your register, you're gonna lose your range, you're gonna lose, and you're probably gonna get health problems a good 20 years before you would otherwise. So why risk it? Why risk your voice just for an addiction? Not smoking also includes not being around other people's smoke. Sadly, secondhand smoke affects us singers. I know that it's annoying, but personally, I stay away from people when they're smoking because I know it affects my voice. I mean, also, I don't like inhaling smoke. It's just a personal thing, so I don't have a problem with it. And number three is super related. Avoid any substance that dries out your throat. And some of these substances, we might not even think about them that often. Caffeine dries your throat. And that's, you know, in soda, in coffee, and in all caffeinated teas. So like green tea and black tea and white tea. I recommend herbal tea, which doesn't have any caffeine in it. Another really important thing that dries out your throat is alcohol. So I personally don't drink any alcohol. I find it unnecessary, but I know some people really like to drink. So if you really like to drink, but you're having trouble with your voice, I advise you to try, at least try to cut back a little, and to drink a lot of water when you're drinking or right after you drink, because that's definitely affecting your throat. Very related to that, number four, stay hydrated. Obviously, we all know that we should drink a lot of water every day, yeah. But what else can you do if you're already drinking a lot of water and your voice is still sore or not where you want it to be in terms of health? If you're suffering from some throat issues, you can do other things. You can drink herbal tea, which is good because then the water will be warm and you can take it to your vocal warm-ups. And then another thing that people do, especially when they're sick, is to inhale steam. If you shower at really high temperatures, then you're already inhaling steam. But if you don't, you can just boil some water on the stove and then turn it off. Take your pot of water and just cover your head with a towel and just try to inhale the steam without burning your face. That's the really simple way, no equipment needed. If you don't want to do that, you can just buy a vapor inhaler. They sell those at pharmacies or supermarkets, And people that suffer from asthma actually use those. Definitely recommend. I have one of those. I rarely use it because I rarely need it. But sometimes, you know, when I'm doing a show several times a week or something, and I know that my throat is like sensitive, I'll have it backstage with me, and maybe like I'll take some Vaporin before. I sound like I'm smoking, but no, I'm inhaling some water vapor before warming up. So yeah, so that's all I use it like backstage, but that's maybe like once a year. But if you're suffering though, if your throat is sensitive, like that might be something to look into. Number five, I don't know why people don't do this. It's like almost all of these tips, I'm like, why isn't this obvious? But I guess it isn't. So number five, go to the doctor when you're sick. So I don't know why people don't do this, but they don't. So this is what usually happens. It's like the day of my lesson and my student will call me up and they'll be like, teacher, I'm sick. What should I take for my throat? Or I'm coughing, or my throat is swollen, or whatever it is. I'm not a doctor, so I can recommend stuff like I'm doing in this video, but at the end of the day, as soon as you see symptoms, you need to call your doctor. That's what I usually do. I mean, I've been to the throat doctor enough times that I've already seen my throat be swollen, I've already seen my throat be itchy, be sensitive, be raspy, and be congested. So I already have like meds for all of that and home remedies for all of that. So I can sort of take care of myself, but that doesn't mean I can prescribe stuff to you. So definitely as soon as you start seeing symptoms, you need to call your doctor. What I do when I start seeing symptoms of something, even if I'm not sure if I'm getting sick or not, I'll start taking medicine because I'm like, I can't afford to be sick. I just can't. Normally I won't get sick, but that's because, you know, I practice what I preach. I do all of these things all the time. You know, I don't drink, I don't smoke, I drink a lot of water, I stay hydrated, and I stay alert. I'm like, okay, as soon as my throat is feeling something weird, I'm like, okay, what is this? What can be causing this? Do I have to sleep more? Do I have to drink more water? Do I have to rest? But you have to be vigilant, because if you're not vigilant, then, you know, your throat is very sensitive. Your throat is very weak, so you have to take care of it. That brings me to step number six, rest. I don't know, it seems like vocal rest isn't a thing, but it's definitely a thing for me. Especially if you're doing shows, you need to rest your voice. Like, I have taken weeks off when I don't speak in extreme cases because my throat is swollen. If your throat is swollen, you need to rest. And if you can't afford to just like not speak for a week, I understand, but then you need to lower the volume of your voice and not sing. Definitely never scream, you know, don't scream, and take it super easy with your voice and try not to talk unless it's really necessary, because your voice needs to rest sometimes. And I feel like people just want to like sing all day and talk, and they don't realize your voice gets tired. Like, if you're a dancer, do you just dance like for the 16 hours a day that you're awake? I don't think so. You know, you warm up, you dance, you warm down, and then you don't dance for the rest of your day. Even if you dance like 6 hours a day, you still rest and you take rest days, right? So same with singing. Tip seven is for people who have like a raspy, itchy feeling. So there's lots of stuff that you can take to give yourself like a protective layer when you feel like your throat has been stripped of it. So people hear like a Chinese remedy called Peipakoa. I don't know how you say it. I don't know if you have it in the States or in other countries, but it's this mixture of Chinese herbs and honey. But you can take straight up honey. You can take a cough drop. Any cough drop, I would advise it doesn't contain menthol, because menthol doesn't do anything good for your throat. Any of those will help soothe you. They won't cure you. They will just soothe you. And I would just advise you to take them sparingly, because the more you take them, the more you feel like you need to take them. But really what you need to do is tackle the root issue, not just take it and take it and take it, because then you'll just take it all the time, but you won't solve the actual issue. I hope that makes sense. Number eight is for people who are congested. And it doesn't matter if you feel like your throat is congested or if you feel like your nose is congested, Same thing. Just take some sort of saline solution. So that can be the nasal sprays that have water and salt in them. You can also just gargle water with salt water. You can just gargle it like 3 times a day and it'll really help clean out your throat. Now there's this thing people are doing, I think it's called a neti pot, where like they clean one side of the nose and the water comes out the other side. I haven't personally tried it, but if you have, let me know how that goes, because that can also help clean out your sinuses. Nothing is gonna act as a decongestant more than actual meds. So for that, of course, ask your doctor. I'm not a doctor. Number 9, I feel like most people don't know, but if you're sick or if your throat is swollen and you wanna protect it, you should avoid coughing. So every time you cough, you're actually like hitting your throat a little bit, especially, you know, if you're coughing like really strongly, you're hitting it pretty hard. And if you're just coughing all day because you're sick, you're doing a lot of damage to your throat. So of course, some coughing you can't help. So if you can't help it, it's okay. You know, there's nothing you can do about it. But if you can help it, then I advise you to swallow instead of coughing, or even like drink some water if you feel like you want to cough. And that'll usually soothe you and distract you from wanting to cough, because sometimes it's just because you're itchy, but you don't have to cough. You can do other things that will protect you and heal you quicker than coughing will. Number 10, and probably one of the most important tips that I can give you, is to always, 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 always warm up your voice. I don't know why people think that they can just, you know, burst out in song without warming up. Maybe it's because people think that if they have great vocals without warming up, they're better singers than people who have to warm up. But everyone should and has to warm up. Warming up is not, you know, it's not for weak singers. It's not for bad singers. It's not for singers in training. It's for everyone. Warming up is so that you don't hurt yourself when you're singing, and so that you don't hurt yourself after you sing for a long period of time. And I've been in many backstage settings where really, you know, mediocre singers don't want to warm up, and then the really great singers are more humble and they actually warm up. I get frustrated when people don't warm up, because then they can't use their voice to their full potential. But think about singing like you think about any other sport, okay? You would not run a marathon without warming up. You wouldn't play a tennis match without warming up. So why are you gonna sing a show without warming up? You wouldn't. Your throat is particularly weak in relation to other muscle groups in your body. Don't hurt it. Don't hurt it on purpose. So go through the list and see, you know, what things are you doing, what things aren't you doing. Hopefully I said at least one new thing that you hadn't learned, and you got something new from this video. If you liked it, please give me a thumbs up and share it with your friends, and definitely subscribe if you haven't already. I'm Daniela. Let me know what the next video should be about in the comments below, and I'll leave all my social media below as well. So see you in the next one. Bye. Yay!